Millions of developers might have just included malware in their code inadvertently, and it's all tying back to a single phishing campaign. The way I found out about this is actually this tweet right here from Solstice. Great follow on Twitter, by the way. And I got a good laugh out of this. 2.8 million weekly downloads for a package instead of just calling array.isarray. This is in response to a very popular NPM package just called is. You get a lot of these convenience packages. I remember one of the first malware examples in NPM that like someone took over a popular project. It was just a few lines of code. So that's what this one is. You include this is package. It saves you some keystrokes. I think in this thread, it talks about maybe there's like a few little bit of features that you don't get out of native JavaScript. But besides the point, this is part of an ongoing and very active phishing campaign. I'm going to pull up a bunch of blogs from Socket. They track all sorts of malware and vulnerabilities in NPM and PyPI, so they got a lot of great info on this entire attack. And this is all stemming from an attacker is registering this typo squatted domain, npnjs.com, instead of npmjs.com. Enough very popular developers actually got this that we have a ton of copies of the actual phishing campaign that we can look at. It looks super legit from NPM. It's a great phishing email. It says, we're reaching out to all users as part of our regular account maintenance to ensure that your account remains secure and fully functional. We kindly ask that you verify your email address. Please click here, log in to re-verify your email address. If you have any questions, concerns, please feel free to reach out to the NPM support team. Seemingly harmless, pretty benign, right? And yeah, a lot of people fell for it. And what's specifically clever here is this is targeting people who are maintaining packages in NPM. So if you have an NPM account, you likely are maintaining some code that other people are using. That's the whole point of NPM. It's the node package manager. You're writing Node.js and you want to include a package, the person who wrote it is going to have an NPM account to upload that code for you to then grab. So these maintainers make very juicy targets for threat actors who are trying to sneak their malware into as much code as humanly possible. After digging around, it looks like it's also being a successful campaign because of some of the email security settings that NPM just doesn't have turned on. So npmjs owns their .com and the .org domain. This is good digging by Sebastian here. So the official, actual, non-phishing npmjs.org domain does not have any DMARC or SPF DNS records. So the spoof.org domain isn't actually flagged as spam. NPM sends its emails through the .com. So if the phishers were going to try to use the .com situation and make it look like it was coming from official NPM, it probably would have got flagged at that point. And while we're on this topic, this is a good segue into today's sponsor of the video, who would provide a lot of help in chasing down a lot of these phishing alerts. This episode is sponsored by DropZone AI. And if you're drowning in security alerts and burning hours on investigations in your SOC, you're going to want to check them out. DropZone is your AI SOC analyst that never sleeps. I've got some hands-on experience with this tool. I've done a demo on my channel before. It answers all of the questions that I would think of as a seasoned incident responder, and it surfaces all of that to the top, not buried 3, 4, 5 clicks deep, and it does all of that in under 10 minutes. An incident response and investigations in your SOC is when speed matters. So their AI tool collects all of the information from all of your different alert sources, and it's going to reason through this end to end with context from all of the different sources that you give it. And it's going to be able to write a full investigation report, and again, 24/7. So you're going to take your tier one SOC analysts and you're going to increase their capacity tenfold with a tool like this. Setup is ridiculously fast. You can be up and running in less than 30 minutes, no code involved. You start integrating your alert sources, and then they're going to start surfacing this kind of investigation information to you right away. So instead of your users reporting every suspicious phishing email, requiring a human to go look at it and go, is this actually phishing? Is this actually malicious? You get an alert like this that's got all of the information that that investigation would ask right away to make much faster decisions. And then equally as powerful, how about all of the alerts that are constantly having to be marked as benign? One of your security tools fires off a bunch of alerts because someone read a bunch of information out of S3 buckets. Well, with all of the additional context that DropZone has, they can look at it and say, actually, that is expected behavior. That user is logged in from an IP address where they consistently logged in from, and that user is expected to perform a backup today. Hit that link in the description below, book a demo, tell them I sent you, they'll take special care of you. Thanks, DropZone, for helping keeping this channel running and for keeping these SOC analysts out there fast, effective, and sane. Thanks, DropZone, for supporting the channel. Be sure to check them out. So let's get into the actual package that is the headline of this whole article. This is package that has over 2.8 million downloads a week. So really quick, jumping ahead, since I know a lot of people don't stay to the end of all of these videos, I do want to pull up the list of packages that were impacted that we know about as of right now. I'll include a link to all this research below so you can read it yourself, but here you go. You want to take a screenshot. These are the packages that we know got malware that fell for that phishing campaign in the last couple of days. The is package is the most popular, but these prettier packages are also super popular. So what happens is the NPM maintainer falls for that phishing campaign, then the threat actor gets access to their account, to their token. They can actually use that access to push malware to that repo that can then just gets like auto sucked up by those 2.8 million people that are downloading this package, especially if you're just pinning it in your package.json to latest and you're not like pinning it to a specific version. So here you can see what it looks like when it's actually included. It's obviously obfuscated. This is like one of the common things that you could look for to try to find malware in NPM packages, like big, weird, obfuscated JavaScript, because most legitimate packages don't have a need to do that. But here you go, deobfuscated. This is the actual code that's winding up in these packages, especially in the is one. I think some of the other one, like the prettiers, were actually targeting Windows DLLs that they were trying to get into this, but in the is package, they just stayed in JavaScript land so that they didn't just focus on Windows. Yeah, here it says the is variant drops no DLL, instead it remains entirely in JavaScript. So here's the JavaScript deobfuscated, so you could check out what it does. Grab some system and networking stuff. Then it's going to spin up some web sockets. It sends some host fingerprinting information back to the C2 server, to the command and control server, and then it actually gets the malware from that command and control server at that point. So even if you were inspecting everything that you were including in this new file, A, it's obfuscated. B, this doesn't look too crazy right off the bat unless you know what you're looking for, because the actual malware doesn't come until later. I don't have a copy of the malware that it grabs, but here they say the payload executes with the same privileges as the host process, which allows unrestricted file system and network access. In addition to harvesting environment variables, where a lot of the sensitive creds and stuff are, it's going to exfiltrate sensitive development contexts, such as the npm rc file and git remotes. So this is hyper targeted towards developers and their environments, because this is where environment variables, npmrc, this is where like all of the secrets in, like good developers aren't hard coding a lot of their secrets. This is where they shovel all of the secret API keys and things like that. If the process has write access, the malware persists by overwriting its own index.js, meaning removal requires more than deleting the node modules. Lock files must also be reset to fully eradicate the infection. That's pretty gnarly. There's lots of conversation going on Twitter and in GitHub comments about all the different packages that people are figuring out fell for this phishing campaign over the last few days. And then here we have some reports of what that Windows DLL version, so not that JavaScript WebSocket thing, the DLL, what it's doing. So this is a thread on Hacker News. It says one user reported that Chrome security flagged potential SSH key compromise and full system reinstallation. They said this is consistent with the malware scraping of browser creds and credential config files like npmrc and netrc. So obviously it caught my attention with that is package being so popular, but like I said, this prettier package set was also impacted a few days ago. And the way that this one was actually caught was via GitHub issue being like, hey, something looks a little fishy here. This diff looks a little odd. I think there's a virus in this DLL. So good eyes to all these people who actually check these diffs and say, doesn't look like it's supposed to be there. Yeah, pulling up that diff. Pretty weird that this actually does include this DLL here, which is not generally super normal, especially in a package like this. Super interesting to actually go and read the GitHub conversation of people realizing that the package is owned. This shows the addition of an installation script and a DLL. The script has this concerning looking, not very obfuscated code. It's trying to call run DLL 32. They're like figuring it out in real time. You could scroll this combo. Whoa, his NPM token must be leaked. He realizes it's a phishing email. He says, I've deleted the NPM token. We'll publish a new version ASAP. And they start doing all the cleanup. Can you mark those bad packages as depreciated? Open source forums are such good learning experiences to find this stuff and like figure out like how people are recognizing this and how they're responding. All right, so this is an important reminder that every time you do an include something at the top of your file, that's actually adding attack surface to your app. So these little conveniences like this is package that apparently gets 2.8 million downloads a week. This is attack surface. How many people out there that had that include in their NPM, you know, their package.json set to latest version to just please grab the latest version for me? How many people actually probably diffed the code and did all that investigation that those people did in the GitHub conversation. How many of those 2.8 million are even going to realize that this happened at all? And then an even more interesting question to me is, where is this going in the future with vibe coding? Yeah, we've seen some AI coding apps like publish vulnerabilities in custom code, but one of the more concerning things that I'm seeing is that they're actually including packages that don't exist. So instead of maybe typo squatting that npm.js domain, what if you typo squatted a package that an AI coding app is including that doesn't exist? And then you could do something like this and people would have no idea because they're not even writing that code themselves. So wrapping up with what you could do and what developers should know is what they say, is you're gonna wanna audit these recent installs for the last couple of days. Just delete your whole node modules folder of whatever was deleted, clear your npm caches, reinstall from clean updated versions, check the known bad versions that we know malware made its way into in the past couple of weeks, pin the exact version numbers, don't do latest. And then obviously if you're an npm developer, please enable 2FA on that account. Share this one with your developer friends out there. I'm trying to get the word out. This is obviously super popular packages and just a super important lesson to learn about this kind of attack surface that a lot of people probably don't even realize. If this was helpful, please hit all the YouTube buttons down below. It helps me more than you know. And if you made it this far in the video, Happy Gilmore 2 comes out the day after I'm recording this. I want you to drop your favorite quote from Happy Gilmore in the comments below. I'm trying to think of the one that I might use most frequently in my daily life. Basically, anytime anything hits my foot, I say, "Your ball struck my foot." And I'm sure I do the Shooter McGavin finger guns way too much in real life. If you're on a Black Hat and DEF CON and interested in doing a meetup with me, I'm including the details of that in my newsletter that goes out tomorrow morning. You can find the subscription link in the description below. Thank you so much. Follow for more cybersecurity news.